Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I want to thank our witnesses today for their presentations. I know that, Mr. Chairman, you indicated you're going to be changing some of the drafting of the bill. You saw some of the drafting was flawed, and you particularly commented about changes in the MTBE area for contaminated drinking water supplies. I appreciate that, but I think that this bill is flawed beyond just the drafting. The, with all due respect, the flaws of this legislation would eliminate all recourse for communities that have lost their drinking water supply to MTBE contamination. There are over 1,500 registered fuels and almost 7,500 registered fuel additives. This legislation would remove all liability for harm caused by these fuels and fuel additives. Some of these additives are rarely used because the oil companies understand that they're powerful contaminants, and if they enter the groundwater, they could do harm. They can damage small engines. They can cause impact on public health. We don't know on this committee the facts for each of these 9,000 fuels and fuel additives, but under this bill, oil companies can now use them with impunity. Consider ETBE, which has many of the same chemical characteristics that have made MTBE such a difficult contaminant to clean up. This bill would exempt oil companies from liability for ETBE contamination. MMT is a fuel additive. It can severely damage engines and potentially endanger the public health. We should not eliminate liability for caused by MMT, but that's what this bill does. MTBE rarely contaminates water by itself. It's usually part of an underground plume of gasoline from leaking underground storage tanks. If we remove the liability shield for MTBE, what about the other constituents in gasoline, such as benzene, that can also contaminate a community's water supply? I certainly welcome greater clarity from the chairman on how he plans to modify the bill. But the point is, to have this committee pick and choose among the 9,000 fuels and fuel additives, providing liability protections for some and not others, sounds like the ultimate case of government picking winners and losers. If we exempt all of these 9,000 fuels and fuel additives, we're not picking winners and losers, except we're picking the losers, because one point is for sure is that if we pass this law and absolve ExxonMobil of any liability for selling unsafe, dangerous, or defective fuels, will remove the incentive for responsible corporate behavior. There are many other reasons why this legislation, I believe, is pretty bad. Section 2 provides that if a convenience store owner determines that his or her underground storage tanks are compatible with a fuel, then the owner is exempt from liability if he leaks pollution if his leaks pollute the neighbor's drinking water. Section 3 says if someone sells you fuel that damages your car or destroys your boat engine, well, you're on your own. Section 4 has a safe harbor provision for all fuels and fuel additives that's similar to the one that Representatives Barton and Bass proposed for MTBE in 2005. That safe harbor is for the future, but protected New Hampshire's lawsuit on MTBE when it was offered in 2005. It said other states couldn't engage in lawsuits. And then it adds a provision to throw out civil actions that are already in court. And on top of that, it prohibits even filing certain civil actions, making it against the law to turn to the courts for justice, runs contrary to our basic values. I may be making some factually incorrect statements because the chairman is revising his bill, but the essence of this bill is to provide exemption from liability. And I'm troubled by exempting from liability people who ought to be held accountable. This is, I think, Washington at its worst. There are trade associations that couldn't agree on this bill. There are real challenges associated with implementing the renewable fuel standards mandated by Congress, but the only thing these trade associations could agree to is to shield themselves from any liability and shift the cost of harm from their product to the consumers or to the taxpayers. And this is not going to solve problems. It's only going to enhance our problems. Mr. Chairman, I regret to say that I have such troubles with this bill. I still hold out the chance that we could work on a bipartisan basis on some of these issues, like reauthorizing our Safe Drinking Water Acts, state of revolving loan fund. That needs to be reauthorized. It should be done in a bipartisan manner. I'm disappointed that we've gone in the opposite direction with this legislation. Rather than working to ensure our communities have safe and affordable drinking water, we're considering legislation to allow oil companies and others to pollute groundwater with impunity. That's very disturbing to me, and I hope that my worst fears are not going to be realized. Yield back my time.